Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Trading Matters Technical Analysis, Chapter 1 Candlesticks. And today we are going to learn about candlestick, that is Marubozu. Marubozu is a long bodied candlestick with no shadows or wicks. So Marubozu is a candlestick that is not having any shadows, and this Marubozu candle can be it is presented two variants. One is red Marubozu, which is bearish Marubozu, and green Marubozu, which is bullish in nature. So, and in this video we are going to discuss about green Marubozu. So let's see green Marubozu characteristics. So this is a normal candle. So we know that for a green candle, open present at the bottom and top is close, and highest peak point is called high and the lower one is low. Now according to Marubozu standard definition, Marubozu is a long body candlestick with no shadows. So let's remove a upper wick. So when you remove upper wick, close is becomes equal to high. So close is equal. Now remove the lower shadow. So then open is equals to low. So Marubozu candle is a candle whose open is equals to low and close is equal to high. And see, according to standard book definition, close should be equals to high, open should be equals to low, but in reality it is not possible always. So we will take some minor considerations, minor variations we will take into consideration, that is up to 0.2%. Means if there is a difference between close and high up to 0.2%, then we will consider it as a Marubozu. So how we will calculate these close and high variation, let's see. So let's take an example. And here a candle whose open is equals to low, but there is a difference between close and high, means you will be having a small wick. So from the graph, let's see, this is the data we are getting. So high is at 1001 and it was closed at 1000 and open is equals to low. Here the percentage difference between high and close is calculated by the given formula, that is high minus close by close into 100. So here we, by substituting the values, high equal to 1001, close equal to 1000 and close equal to 1000, the answer will be 0.1%. So 0.1% is less than 0.2%, which is the allowed value to consider a Marubozu. So this given candle is considered as Marubozu, and we will place a trade on this one. So this is completely valid. And let's see example 2. And here's a candle with the difference between high and close. So let's see high value at 101 and close at 100 and open is equals to low. So same, we will take the same formula, and after submitting these values, we are getting the percentage is 1%. 1% is very greater than 0.2%. That's why this candlestick is do not considered as a Marubozu. So we will avoid trading this one. So what are the conclusions we have made from this is, let's see, four different kinds of candlesticks, in which the second one is having a smaller wick and third one is having a longer wick, upper wick, and fourth one is having a lower peak. So in the first case, open is equals to low and close is equals to high, and this is following the standard definition of a Marbusum. So placing a trade on this Marbus is valid. And in the second case, low, in the last case, close is equals to high, but the low is different from the open. So when a candle is having lower wick, even though its close is equal to high, we will avoid trading that Marbus candle. Means we do not consider it as a Marbus. And in the second case, open is equals to low and close is different from high. And by using the formula, we will calculate the percentage. If that percentage variation is up to 0.02%, then we will place the trade and we will consider this candle as a Marbusum, and that trade is valid. And in the third case, open is equals to low, but the difference between close and high is large. And here, if the percentage is greater than 0.2%, that's why we do not consider it as a Marbusum and we do not place any trade. So that kind of candlesticks are available. Next, see green Marbus candles with abnormal length. So the green candlesticks with abnormal length are avoidable, means we do not place any trade. Why? Because if the green Marbus candle is too short, then it indicates that there is no much buyer's value. So that's why we will avoid the trade, because the upside movement may be happened or may not be happened. When the green Marbus candle is having too long, means too length, then we don't place any trade. Why? Because placing stop loss will become a problem, and this we will discuss in the end of this video. Green Marbus indications. So what a green Marbus candle indicates to us? See, a green Marbus indicate a stock has traded strongly in up direction throughout the session. Means green Marbus candle indicates that the day the total traders are bullish in nature. The green Marbus candle indicates that buyers controlled the price of the stock from the opening bell to close of the day. It's completely the traders are on buy mode. So simply we can conclude that the green Marbus is considered as very bullish in nature. Next, green Marbus area of value. So area of value is the place where we can get profit by placing a trade. So area of value is a location where trading a particular candlestick will give you profit. So the area of value for Marbus. A green Marbus is valuable anywhere in the chart irrespective of the prior trend. Means some candles are having area of value in uptrend, means by placing a trade in the uptrend you will get profit, and some candles give you profit in downtrend, some candles will give you sideways trend. But green Marbus candle, Marbus candle itself is a candle which will give you profitable trade in any trend, uptrend or downtrend or sideways trend, whatever the trend is, irrespective of the prior trend you can place a trade. Let's see a graph, and here the last candle in formed is Marbus, and if you observe the trend, it is having series of higher highs and higher lows. So you can say that the given trend is uptrend, and in this uptrend Marbus is formed at the top of an uptrend. So at the top you will be having Marbus. Even at the top of an uptrend also, Marbus can be traded. Marbus will give you profitable trade. So top of an uptrend is also area of value for Marabou's. And here in another graph, Marabou's is formed at the bottom. So if you observe the trend, it is having series of lower highs and lower lows. So we can say that that given trend is downtrend, and the location of a Marabou's is bottom of an downtrend. And even at the bottom of an downtrend also, Marabou's can be, you can place a trade depending on Marabou's formation. So bottom of an downtrend is also area of value for green Marabou's. And this is by observing the graph, you can say that market is moving sideways. So this is sideways trend. And if a Marabou's formed in sideways also, you can place a trade. Means sideways trend is also, sideways location is also area of value for Marabou's. So simply, wherever, whatever the trend, whether it is uptrend, downtrend, sideways trend, one, wherever the location of the Marabou's, you can place a trade by predicting the direction. So now we are going to learn about green Marabou's potential direction. So potential direction means after placing the trade, which direction the market going to move. So irrespective of the prior trend, green Marabou's formation indicates that the potential direction will be along upside. So in an uptrend, after the Marabou's formation, you can expect that the potential direction will be along the upside. And in a downtrend, after the formation of Marabou's, you can expect the potential direction along upside. And even in sideways trend, after the formation of Marabou's, you can expect the potential direction along upside. So among all these, irrespective of prior trend, whether it is uptrend, downtrend, sideways trend, a green Marabou's formation always indicates the potential direction will be, by looking at the Marabou's, we can predict that the momentum will be along upside. Next, green Marabou's entry. So where we can place a, where we can enter the market. Buy around the closing price of a bullish Marabou's. So we will buy the stock around the closing price of a bullish Marabou's. So let's take a graph. And top of a Marabou's always indicates the closing price. So we will take the, we will place the trade at closing price of a green Marabou's. Now this can be of two types, means you can place the trade in two different ways. One is you can place the trade around the closing price on the same day as the pattern forms, or you can place the trade around the same closing price on the next day after doubly confirming the trend. So how will we place on the same day? See, when green Marabou's forms, we will place the trade few minutes before the closing price of the day session. So why few minutes before? Means if you place 1 hour before, in that 1 hour the market may fall, which is giving you a week, which gives you the difference between high price and close price greater than 0.2, that invalidates the Marabou's. So that's why we will place just few minutes before the closing price, then the Marabou's will remains Marabou's. And the next day, so next day also we will try to place the order around the closing price of the candle, previous day Marabou's candle. But what is the advantage of placing the next day is, next day you can observe that the next day candle is forming above the closing price or below the closing price. Means there are two chances. If the candle may form above the closing price, or the next day candle may form below the closing price. If it is formed above the closing price, so here we can doubly confirm that the trend is going to move in upside direction. So we will place a trade. Or in the next day, if the candlestick open below the closing price, so we do not place any trade. Green Marabouzou stop loss. So where we can set a stop loss. Place the stop loss around green Marabouzou candles low. So this is a Marabouzou candle, and bottom of a Marabouzou considered as low, and here we will place the stop loss. And we know that we are placing top of the candle, means closing price. We are buying at the closing price. We are keeping stop loss at the low, and that's why we do not trade. So here our loss will be the difference between buy and stop loss. That's why we do not place larger, means lengthy Marabouzou candles. We do not trade the lengthy Marabouzou candles. Why? Because the difference between buy and stop loss will be large. That leads to a big losses. So that's why we avoid trading lengthier Marabouzou candles.